We can't fire the forges.
Let me guess. Zoltan told you to piss off.
Literally.
As a personal favor to him, yes.
So this is what happened while I was speaking with Zoltan.
Well, at least he didn't beat about the bush.
There'll be no talking him round. Not after what I did.
Which is what exactly? If we're to help, we need to know. What turned the village against you?
I left. Dravosht. Zoltan. The burden of leadership our dying master dropped in our laps. All of it. There are two kinds of smiths in this world, you see. My kind, who are in it for the love of the craft. Who labor on a single piece from dawn to dusk to get it just right. And the other kind, who are in it for different reasons. People like Zoltan, whose work is quick and cheap. The kind of smiths who shit out a few hundred blades, reap the profit, and divvy it up among themselves. There wasn't a single day we weren't each other's throats. And bit by bit, people started taking sides. You would have torn Dravosht in half had it gone on. So, I left.
You didn't have to do that.
Zoltan's a better chief than I would have been. His way of doing things kept food on people's tables. Dravosht prospered without me and my lofty ideals getting in the road. Until the crystals run out at any rate. Without magic to fire the furnaces, this place is as good as dead.
It depends on how you look at it, though. There's got to be other ways of making fire. We manage it in the Deadlands.
Exactly.
Thanks to Sid's ingenuity, yeah.
What?
He saw all of this coming. New crystals were the problem, not the solution. And spent years coming up with ways of...
Rub two sticks together.
You know what I mean, though, right?
Friction.
Where there's a will, there's a way. What I'm trying to
say
is...
Get some kindling.
It's not your fault.
Dry plants.
You predicted this.
It doesn't matter whose fault it is. I don't want to be the greatest smith alive just because I happen to be the last. Clive. Dravosht won't last long without his furnaces. So, do you think it's time we shed Sid's bellows with the world? The way I see it, it's your decision to make.
Hold on, Blackthorn. Sid made those things for us. They give us an edge over the rest. And you'd be throwing it away.
All right. Do it. This place was your home. I won't abandon it to its fate. Sid's creations were never meant to be hoarded.
They're meant to help the world.
It was only ever a matter of time before we shared them. Let this be another step on the road to freeing Valisthea from the prison of the Crystal's blessing. Dravosht will show the world that it's possible. Wouldn't you agree, August?
When you put it that way, of course. It's like hearing Sid speak from beyond the grave.
Thank you, Clive.
Shall I go and fetch the plans, then?
I know I'm off by heart. I'll be needing some help, though. Building a furnace isn't exactly a one-man job. Do us a favor and round up anyone strong enough to lug a brick or two, would you, August?
All right, then.
And I've got a job for you too, Clive. Finding me some salamander skin. I need leather for the bellows and nothing else will withstand the heat. Luckily for us, salamanders feed out in the fields of Carava.
Time for a spot of hunting, then.
There was a salamander down the other road, but I guess they want me to go for this one. Particular desert salamander.
Sid tried all sorts of leather to make those bellows, but salamander skin was the only kind that worked. Luckily for all our sakes, salamanders aren't too hard to find around these parts.
Make the bellows,
bro. Don't worry, I'll get Blackthorn the help he needs. Once I've worked out who hates us the least.
Alright, off we go then. Everything respawned? No. Okay. Well, in that case, whoops.
Fly, Ambrosia.
Uh, That's a curl. See, does that look about as big as those spiders? No. That's at least 6 times the size of one of those spiders. Unless maybe it was a curl kitten that he was talking about.
Let's make this quick, shall we?
Come on. Oh, I forgot I had this attack. God damn it, I haven't been using lunge. We're fighting the other beasts.
Nice try. Nice try.
Oh jeez, I don't have like any limit break, my bad. I didn't see that. Oh fine, we're still gonna make do with what we've got here. Okay, he's dead. Not as tough as the usual beasties. Salamander skin. Some species of salamander are wont to shed their tails in order to escape predators. Alas, all those of sufficient size to provide the embellished stretch of skin that Cid's bellows require have no predator but mankind, and are disinclined to part with their appendage. I can't say I blame them.
That would be enough for a decent set of bellows.
I wouldn't want to separate from my own appendage. That could mean anything. I guess I could have fast traveled back, but whatever. You can role play a little bit, walk around like how I used to in Final Fantasy XIV. Still do a lot of times. I don't use the Ethernet, I just run. Ride a mount. Saves me Gil.
All about then?
Dunno. Some kind of new invention.
Good news, Clive. When I told people we'd be building them a new furnace, they were practically falling over themselves to help. Talk about changing their tune, eh?
Any trouble finding the skin?
Nothing I couldn't handle.
It'd be awkward if I couldn't find the skin, wouldn't it?
Could you find the skin? Nope. Well, shit.
There should be plenty. Right then, time to put these lads to work. If everyone pulls their weight, we'll be finished in no time.
Well, that was easy.
Well, I'll be damned. I honestly didn't think it'd work. But it's hot enough, all right. And without a single crystal in sight.
You know what this means, don't you?
I do, yeah. Dravosht is saved.
Is that? That's not Barden from Vermintide,
sorry,
is it?
About it, yeah.
There's no way. And it's hard as balls finding who the voice actors are of side characters in games, so of NPCs.
I take back everything I said. That thing you built us is an honest to God's marvel. You've saved our village.
It's Blackthorn you should be thanking. He oversaw the construction.
Give this to him, would you?
What is it?
Pet coal cinders. After he left, I spent years trying to eke the most out of our forges. That there was my answer. Chuck it in the fire. And your forge will burn hotter for longer, which will do wonders for your steel. Our secret for yours. Only fair. I've always envied Blackthorn. Since the day I became chief, I spent every spare moment trying to match up to the bastard. No amount of sleepless nights at the Anvil will ever bridge that gap, though. He's a genius. Plain and simple. The man Dravosht needed. But he took all his talent and left. Gifted and free. Is it any wonder I hate his guts?
The cinders would mean more coming from you.
I need to forgive him first. And that's not gonna happen.
Well, you know what they say. Oriflam weren't built in a day and all that. These things take time. Especially when they involve two geezers who hold grudges tighter than their hammers. But what matters is, Blackthorn's got that twinkle back in his eye. And I'd call that a job well done.
So would I.
I reckon he's gonna be at it a while yet, though, so why don't you head off without us? I'll see that the old git gets home safe and sound.
See that you both do. I'll save the cinders till then.
All right. It'll be a nice little surprise for him. He's still explaining the ins and outs of the new forge, so I doubt we'll be going anywhere for a bit. No sense you waiting around anyway.
These things are going to take some getting used to.
Yeah. Give it a week, and you'll wonder why you ever bother with crystals. Let's run through it again, shall we?
Bloody hell. How's it staying so hot without a crystal?
Don't ask me, but whoever invented this thing was a fucking genius.
It's not exactly like Barden, but it sounds like the same voice actor doing a very similar grovelly voice.
I'll bet the blacksmiths will be queuing up to buy you a drink now. Reckon you might have saved this town and everyone in it.
Hey, that's not Blackthorn, is it? Never thought I'd see his face in Dravosht again.
Okay, well, with that, do we have a new entry at all? We do, Dravosht. A town located in the rugged mountainous mining region of central Dalmechia. It is known for its ironwork, and armor and weaponry forged here is long enjoyed a reputation as the realm's finest. This is in no small part due to the quality of ore the mines produce, as well as the veritable army of local blacksmiths whose skills are said to be unrivaled. And of course, if that is Barden's voice actor, it would be a fucking smithing village. You know, because he basically, what I know him from various games, is he voices dwarves in a lot of fantasy games, like Warhammer Vermintide. I think he voices one of the dwarves in RuneScape, etc., etc. So, okay, so now we got to go back to the hideout for all three of our stuff. Alright, let's head to the infirmary first, because it's the closest. Or it's the furthest away from the other two, I guess. Or whatever, it's not the furthest away, the Morble one will be, but... You know what, screw it, never mind, stop talking.
Thank goodness you're back. Taya looks like she's about to collapse.
Is this what you needed?
Sorry, I had to help a town build a forge.
Yes, it is. Thank you, Clive. I'm loath to give a patient Alicia, but Tyler's right. Sometimes it's all we can do. A single dose dulls even the most agonizing pain, and all other sensation with it. It may be a gentle way to die, but it is death nonetheless. I wish there was another way.
How are you feeling?
Gee, I wonder.
Light, Medhir. Drifting on waves.
Good. Just relax. Let the waves carry you to a better place.
Thank you, Daya. I'm so proud of you.
He's gone. Thank you, Rodrigo. And you, Clive?
I'll see that he's properly laid to rest.
The man you helped today was my mentor, back in the Southern Isles, on the front lines of some meaningless war. I was still a child when they shipped me to their triage tents. To treat the wounded with my gift. But in such blighted lands, I was next to useless. Until he taught me the true physicker's art, that is.
An art we would be lost without.
Tears of mercy were his gift to the bearers of the world. A respite from the agony of the curse's end.
And a kindness Cid would have approved of.
You know as well as I what life is like for a bearer soldier. Marched from one battle to the next, never knowing which might be your last. A commander may care nothing for the bearer spent in his service, but my mentor's gift gave the dying one fleeting moment of tranquility before the end. I've no tears left, Clive. I've seen too many of my friends taken. Something needs to change. And we need to be the ones to change it.
And we will.
And we will.
Oh, you see?
I promise.
You owe me a Coke. This one right here.
I hope so.
Quest complete. Tears of Mercy. 70... No, I don't know. I don't know why I thought I got 75 right now and I only got 25. More? You can't. More?
So we're truly free. We won't need to make decisions like these.
Oh god, he turned into full stone. How are you gonna. Why did Kupka turn into dust after he turned to stone?
Clive, I wanted to give you something for the kindness you showed my mentor.
What's this?
A chest of all the medicines you're ever likely to need. Seeing as you're so reluctant to come to the infirmary, I thought you might as well take a part of the infirmary with you.
I'm sure it will be very helpful indeed. And Taya, try not to work too hard.
And work Rodrigo all the harder, you mean? He's a quick study, but he's got a long way to go yet. I'll take that particular piece of advice when you heed it yourself, thank you very much. Besides,
fair enough.
Who else is going to see that your brother takes his medicine?
Who indeed?
Medicine chest.
I'm glad I was there for his final moments. He deserved the peace he chose.
That wasn't another quest. What the hell's a medicine chest? A beautifully carved chest that opens to reveal countless compartments full of tonics and tinctures. Seeing as you're so reluctant to come to the infirmary, I thought you might as well take a part of the infirmary with you, Taya. Oh, it's a Clive's chamber thing.
Gentlemen, I see you both made it home in one piece.
Yeah, well, we didn't want to outstay our welcome. The whole village turned out for a go on the bellows after you left. Everyone except Zoltan has. Didn't see eye nor hair of him.
Oh, but that reminds me. I have something for you.
Pit coal cinder. Sooty black shards recently removed from the equally sooty black depths of the... Mines. Scattering them over a fire produces a hot crimson flame for which effect the substance has long been highly prized by desert fortune tellers looking to strike the fear of the inferno into their superstitious client.
Pit coal cinder. How'd you come by this?
Well, you see, this is how I managed to get my hands on this. Oh, wow, I've never seen the texturing in the side of the airship before.
I'm sure. He didn't say so, but I think he wants to forgive you.
Imagine that. Yeah, you know I could never leave this place, don't you? Every time you put on mail, you and the Curse Breakers are trusting me with your lives. There's no greater honor for a smith than that. I'm not about to go crawling back to Zoltan for forgiveness, but I will make good use of his cinder. And if that helps save even a single life, then he'll have my gratitude. What was it you said he called me? Huh? A genius? And he spent sleepless night trying to copy me, did he? Sounds like I better get to work. I've got a reputation to uphold.
It's good to see you back on form, Blackthorn.
I don't know how you pair put up with me sometimes. But I'm grateful all the same. Now, where was I? Oh yeah, about to put Zoltan back in his place.
Ain't got the art to tell him how similar they are. Stubborn bastards.
A little healthy competition should be good for him.
You're not wrong. Still, it's a shame him and Zoltan couldn't let bygones be bygones. No use grumbling about it now, though. Blackthorn's happy. Or as near to happy as he gets. And that's good enough for me.
Oh, I got a design draft. A diagram detailing the steps to craft a belt to end all belts. Okay. Ouroboros? I don't know what that's referencing. Now, the question is, do I have the materials for it?
What do I owe the honor? What do you want?
No, I do not. I need a stone tongue, and I need... Oh my god, I need I need the cum ore. I didn't even know that was a real ore. Okay, fantasy ore, maybe. I'm not really sure, but... So shall the end feed a new beginning... Having found this leather belt adorned with the ancient seal of the Devourer of Worlds, your search for the perfect wasteware is over, or has it just begun? So I don't even have that ore stuff. And Stone Tongue. Is there a basilisk in this game? There's not really many entries on the bestiary left, but I'm trying to think of enemies that stone you. I mean, lots of enemies in Final Fantasy games stone you, but a basilisk is the first one that comes to mind.
That it? Fine.
Alright, well, it wasn't that big of an upgrade anyways, so it's not like I'm missing out at the moment. But when we get a hold of that ore and presumably the tongue, unless it's one of those S ranks that I haven't fought yet, because those are getting kind of old now.
Sid, can't help but notice that your satchel is twitching in a most violent manner.
Oh, sorry, that's just me.
Yeah. It's your problem now.
I was thinking about Jill. Oh, shut up.
What an amazing specimen. The flesh positively throbs with vitality.
Stop!
If I can successfully graft this to the Morgan Beards...
No, don't graft my flesh!
When I successfully graft this to the Morgan Beards, I suspect the results will be immediate. I shall begin at once.
Sometime later, I guess we just sat around and watched plants grow. Look at those butterflies in sync. Well, they were, I guess. This place is pretty. I like it.
It is just as I hoped. Witness how the Morganbeards have taken to the blighted soil. How they bloom with heretofore unseen vigor. Why, I dare say such a vine graft would yield similar results when applied to other specimens as well.
I'm glad I could be of assistance.
You've not only helped us, Sid. You've saved us. Do you recall the extract with which I provided you before? I took a moment to distill some more, but this time with the petals from the invigorated Morganbeards. And would you believe? Its potency has nearly doubled. You must accept this phial as thanks for your assistance. The rest, I shall give to Taya.
Okay, so now my potions just do better again. Well, I'm not going to complain about that. And it's going to be real unfortunate if one of those plants grows into a morble right in the middle of the hideaway. Invigorated Morganbeard Extract. If adding the extract of Morganbeard petals to curative or performance-enhancing potions increases their potency, then imagine what adding the extract to Morganbeard petals fortified with the vigor of a morble gripped with madness might do. Necessary for further increasing consumable potency. Consumable potency maximized. You have obtained a phial of invigorated Morganbeard extract, further increasing the potency of most consumables. Both potions and high potions now restore even more HP, while strength, stone skin, and lionheart tonics last even longer.
Allow me to thank you again, Master Sid. I do believe you have quite a knack for this sort of work. Should you ever grow tired of saving the realm, we would happily welcome your assistance here in the backyard on a permanent basis. I jest, of course.
I didn't do anything. I went out and hunted a monster for you. That's what I did. I didn't do anything with the plants.
A few more of these, and the Deadlands will seem less dead.
Well, it's the first step in regrowing the continent.
These flowers are beautiful. But here we have to boil them all down to make medicine.
Well, you just grow more.
Trader from across the sea once told me that on the continent they...
Okay, so is that everything here? We got new music and something I have to check there. Okay, well, I'll grab those or check those or update those or whatever, and then we finally get to set off and go help our folks. Because holy balls. That didn't take too long. There's some interesting stuff in there. So I got an upgrade for increasing my potency. So that means I still probably need another upgrade for,
I will not forget this kindness, my lord. I shall go to Eastport, but as soon as the rebuilding work is complete, I promise to return.
I need to... What was I talking about? Right, upgrade the amount that I can carry. Clive often proved a difficult patient, reluctant to come to the infirmary. Taria commissioned this curio that he might take part of the infirmary with him. It doesn't really make much sense, to be honest. You know, they make it sound like he's going to be carrying it around with him. Maybe someone like Goots could carry this around on his pack. But what am I going to do? I just put it in my chambers, my quarters over here, which is only, you know, a 20-second walk away from the infirmary.
If it's knowledge you seek, we've tones of plenty to guide you.
Which song should we listen to?
All of them.
No, you already tried that and it broke things. I'm trying to figure out if I recognize this. I think I do, but this plays in like I'm actually gonna set it. This plays in like when you're, I almost want to say like when you're in a story location. Okay, well, anyways, without further ado, it is time that we set off for Canver. The Ironworks. Established within a natural sea cavern situated near the outskirts of Old Canver, the Ironworks serves as a discreet berth for Mid's greatest creation. So this is her new magnum opus. If it works. And it looks like... it looks kind of badass. Well, it certainly makes up for the frickin' shit we get in Final Fantasy XIV. Even if it can't fly. Which is a shame.
Be proud of you, Mid. His writings may have helped, but this achievement is all yours. Can we catch them?
The Einar's one of the largest, fastest vessels ever built. And it won't help she has the wind at her back. Any other ship would be hard pressed to keep pace with her, let alone reel her in. But this isn't any other ship. This is the Enterprise! And the world's never seen anything like my dad's engine.
It certainly hasn't.
Ugh.
What do you know of Barnabas Tharm?
That he kicked me in the chest and that was enough to defeat my ass.
Only what the bards sing. And he sailed to Ash from southern lands. That it was his mastery of the blade which won him the throne. And that his sword... Odin's sword can sever the very threads of creation. But don't lose any sleep over a last tilt. We'll do what we must to survive.
What we must.
Now what?
I thought this cove was meant to be hidden.
Is that a Kashyyyk? There's blue.
Company!
Eh?
We'll hold them off until the ship is ready. But hurry!
Bullets! All hands! Man your stations!
That was awesome. I don't know why. Look, even Torgel's gonna man a station. Oh, who's here, though?
Everyone with me?
Oh, jeez. I love this game. Oh, it is a Kashyyyk. Yeah, I saw the blue sparklies.
Here they come.
That's a lot. That is a lot.
I'll take care of these fuckers.
Behind! I'll have you know Earthbreaker here. One struck fear into the heart of every man in the cliffs.
I think I'm gonna need help from this here. Oh shit, I wasn't paying attention to the guy on the right. Did I dodge too early? Big surprise. Got a what? Wait.
20 summers. Come on then. Which of you lot fancies meeting Ogre Killer next?
Hold on.
It was called Heartbreaker.
Hold on. She has an intercom? You've got to be kidding me.
More.
There was no way that that should have hit me. Just saying. He swings at ground level. I'm way up in the air and it still hits me. Okay. No, I fucked that up. Because I saw his attack coming, so I tried to cancel, but it still didn't help me. Well, bring him down on his knees a little bit. I'm going to assume that this is probably the last guy, so I'm just going to start going ham. Now please tell me we're setting sail, because we gotta get the hell out of here.
That was easy enough.
All right, you lousy lot. Get your asses on board. She's ready to sail.
You heard the captain.
She must have like a loud... when I say like intercom, like a loudspeaker, I'm not saying... What the hell?
But I thought he was...
Confounded. Then it is as I feared. Sleipnir is no man, but a creation of Odin.
What does that mean? What? I can't fight...
Phoenix's fiery fundament. Have you no normal enemies?
Are you fucking kidding me?
Up for another round?
Of course we are. Right, Lord Rosfield?
My boy, there was a time people called me the Executioner. Or was it my axe? No matter, heads will roll all the same. Mate, new plan! You leave! We follow!
Follow? Swimming, are you? Oh, bugger me! Weigh anchor! Engine dead slow ahead!
I don't know why it's so epic.
Have care, my friends.
What?
It's not blood that runs through an eggy's veins. These foes will not fall easily.
Everything is...
They will fall.
Like oaks before a woodman's axe. Good thing I brought one!
At least they're not as strong as the other one. Everything's on cooldown, so...
As long as it takes. Unless you have a better idea.
Well, I've already killed at least 5 of the bastards.
Fuck it! Let's do the luck!
Shit. More.
In your own time, why?
Right, run for it.
Ah. Not super graceful. Son of a bitch. It's even got a paddle wheel. The Enterprise has successfully escaped, I think.
Now, mate!
Alright, engine fire! And hold on tight!
That's fucking awesome. It's just like, oh my god, it's just like when you're on the Fahrenheit. And you hear, and Sid's like using the loudspeaker to talk to you while you're on the deck fighting the giant worm. That is so awesome. That ship also looks pretty. Oh, it's got little ships on it. The ship is so big it has little ships. Great, she's in this position again. But at least she's alive.
What do you want?
That's quite a mess you've made. And wholly unnecessary. You are my offering to Muthos. I would not see you damaged.
So she's bait, in other words.
Now back to your stations! Every bell spent treading water puts another leak between us and the galleon.
I don't suppose Mid has a spare engine? Since you rose from the grave, my fortunes have plummeted. Are you absolutely certain of this quest of yours, Clive? The foes you face are as terrible as they are numerous.
Aye, and they'd have us live and die on their terms, which should answer your question.
You have that same stubborn look as your father did when he set his mind to something. On the battlefield, I am but a single axe. A deadly one, mind, but a single one nonetheless. Yet what you require is 1,000, and I believe my old friend in Brandalar can provide them. Take care, Clive. I have many more tales of your father's exploits to share. And I cannot very well do that if you're dead. Again.
Good luck, Uncle. And may fair winds attend you.
As for you, Joshua, take care.
I shall do my best, Uncle.
Farewell, my nephews. When next you see me, it shall be with an army at my back.
Fucking Uncle Byron.
Cheerio!
Gee, I could go for some Cheerios right now. I'm hungry.
Oh, yeah. Do keep up, my boy!
So he's going off to recruit an army of
axes,
I guess.
Showing us up now, can we?
We would never hear the end of it.
Why am I getting messages again?
Ugh.
I see. So he's returned.
Rigor of mercy. What have I done?
My lord.
You again. Who are you? Also, isn't this supposed to be where that storm started? It looks pretty clear here. Well, okay, it's cloudy, but it doesn't look swirling. Okay, so now we are the Naldia Narrow. Blessed with mild currents and warm waters, the Narrow allows for swift travel to the Dominion, Oriflam, and Stoneher without having to circle through the dangerous outer seas. Why are the outer seas dangerous? I don't like that. So we're at open sea right now. Be a great moment for Leviathan to show up and just eat us. That is badass looking, the way that she's added the fallen pieces onto it.
Between here and Walud, but any ship heading north has to round Zemeckis and put through the Narrow. Maintain our current bearing north-northeast, and we'll catch the Black Galleon before she vanishes again.
What's to prevent her from circling around Ash from the south?
With these winds in those waters, it'd take them forever and a fortnight to reach Stoneher.
Stone here? Stone here?
Knows what she's talking about, Clive. Better than any of us lot, anyway. I see we do as she tells.
Oh, great.
Sails on the horizon.
She's ours.
Oh, okay. I thought it was a monster. I thought it was Sin or something.
Look alive, boys! Pull ahead! And keep those furnaces fed!
Aye, aye!
Feel that,
Jill.
All hands! Battle stations!
She's waited her whole life to say that.
Let's see what this girl can do.
He's ready.
So does the other follow. The bond of consciousness which joins them condemning both to the same fate. Yet my every attempt to strike it from their hearts serves only to tighten its hold. Fascinating. There is naught my blade cannot sever.
This game has everything, I swear. Oh, Targol's not blue anymore. We're just going for it. guess that's what the big ram was for on the front. To do things like that.
It's now or never.
I'll find her.
Can nobody see the floating suit of armor? Oh, shit. Through the maelstrom. Through the maelstrom! This is all Leviathan's shit.
Where did you hide her, Barnabas?
But I guess because Leviathan's not in the game. Well, I guess Leviathan is in the game through the DLC, though, but not the core game. They had to make reference somehow. Damn it, I was hoping to hit both of them with that. Oh, look! Okay, stop. I'm getting all... I got a stupid grin on my face. It's back. Fuck off, you little son of a bitch. Fuck off. Shit. Okay. Now it's just you and me. Well, both of us, rather. Yes, I got both of them. Although I didn't kill that one. Great. This guy. Well, I managed to get some hits in there, thankfully. I thought he froze. Not, oh shit, I pressed R2, or I pressed L2 instead of R2, goddammit. I did that out of order, but whatever. We got him. Can you save right now? Oh my god, you can save. Oh, okay, this episode's like 8 minutes short, but that's fine. I think this is a good place to save. I have no idea how cutscene intense things might get. We might get into a fight. I don't know if we're going to be fighting against Odin at this point, so I'm going to just save it while we're here. In the next episode, we'll continue, try to find Jill, get the hell out of here, maybe kick Barnabas's ass, and hope everyone on the Enterprise is alright.